the truth of the thing they themselves were declaring. Namely, that Jesus was the Christ. I could understand them persecuting Joseph and the rest of us if he had said, I am Christ, or if he had said there is no Christ, or if he had said someone else is Christ, then Christians believing in Christ would be justified to some extent at least in persecuting or disputing with him at least. But what he said was, he whom ye ignorantly serve, declare I unto you. Paraphrasing what Paul said in Athens, he whom ye ignorantly worship, declare I unto you. And Joseph came to Christians and said to them, you've been claiming to believe in Jesus Christ. I say to you that I saw him and I talked with him. He is the Son of God. When Joseph came out of that wood, at least four fundamental truths came out with him, and he announced them to the world. First, that the Father and the Son are separate and distinct individuals. Secondly, that the canon of Scripture is not complete. Thirdly, that man was created in the image of God. And fourth, that revelation, for the channel between the earth and the heaven is open and is continuous. I'd like to say to you students, there's nothing, so far as I'm concerned, in all our claims, finer and more challenging to students in any field of activity than the one which says, we not only believe what God has revealed and does reveal, but we believe that he will yet reveal many great and important things pertaining to the kingdom of God. That is a challenge to research. It's a challenge to check on what you've believed. It's a challenge to bring your beliefs, your thoughts, your education, your lives up to date. May I just say to you, and perhaps some of you are wondering, what was the reaction of this judge when we'd finished? He sat and listened intently. He asked some very pointed and searching questions. And at the end of the period, he said, Mr. Brown, I wonder if your people appreciate the import of your message. Do you? He said, if what you have told me is true, it is the greatest message that has come to this earth since the angels announced the birth of Christ. This was a judge speaking, a great statesman, an intelligent man. He threw out the challenge, do you appreciate the import of what you say? He said, I wish it were true. I hope it may be true. God knows it ought to be true. I would to God, he said, and he wept as he said it, that some man could appear on the earth and authoritatively say, thus saith the Lord. As I intimated, we did not meet again, but I bring you just in the briefest form two or three reasons why I believe that Joseph Smith was a prophet of God. But undergirding and overarching all the rest, I say to you from the very center of my heart, I know that Joseph Smith was a prophet of God. And all of these evidences and many others that could be cited may have the effect of giving me, in a sense, an intellectual conviction. But by the whisperings of the Holy Spirit, one may come to know. And by those whisperings, I say, I do know. And I thank God for that knowledge and pray for his blessing upon all of you. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.